Sign up for Bluehost today and get your own cyberspace for just $3.95 a month. Just go to mysite.thefakist.com to get started.
Catch Birdman Stan on The Fakest. He takes the lazy eye in the sky right into the heart of the action.
The Fakest brings you fake stories about all the misery in the world. Tonight, that misery hits close to home as we mourn the loss of helicopter pilot Stan Buttram, who died while covering a protest of his own volition and with no encouragement from the fakest himself, Paul Daffo. They say that time is the fire in which we burn. But in Stan's case, it was a fiery helicopter crash. Birdman Stan, as he was known to the fakest faithful, was equal parts endearing and reckless. But above all else, he had a reputation as a hell of a heli journalist. Tonight, a tribute to a man who flew 597 feet too far, with love in our hearts and minds through the final ad break. The Fakest proudly presents
Birdman Stan, Fly High, a hastily thrown together tribute to the man whose lazy eye in the sky drifted towards heaven far too soon. Brought to you by McDonald's, the place for food, fries, and fun, as well as a star-studded cast of sponsors, since we're expecting a lot of eyes on this one. Now, your grief-stricken host, Paul Daffo.
Thanks, Planet of the Apes, Malcolm McDowell. Good evening, you schmucks. Thanks for joining us, I guess. You're the only good thing I have in my sad little life now that Stan bit the dust. He was my only, my dearest friend, up until a couple of months ago anyway.
What happened a couple of months ago?
Don't worry about it. Before we get to all the sad shit, let's cover some breaking news.
Breaking news.
This week, the Supreme Leader himself made a shocking revelation in an historic interview. We have the exclusive clips that prove even monsters have a human side.
Welcome to Klaus and Pa's Teen Wolf Fancast, for spitting the hottest theories, news, and general speculation about the hit 80s movies, Teen Wolf and Teen Wolf 2.
Hey, Pa here. Now, if you want to gab about that Twilight ripoff shit, get back to Tumblr.
I'll howl to that. Oh.
The Claus and Paws Teen Wolf Fancast, founded by Claus Gleason and Randy Paw Shuttle in 2010, has released over 180,000 hours of content centered around the classic Michael J. Fox film Teen Wolf, best known for having a penis in the background during one scene.
We've been going at it for 4 nights a week for like
8 years. God damn, has it been that long?
Yeah, 8 years now. With 4 downloads a week, you could say that the waves of the information superhighway are ours to command.
Hey, give me a keg of beer.
Don't worry, that's from the movie. He does that.
If the 4 downloads per week weren't enough to justify the time spent on the podcast, a recent guest propelled the two nebbish young men into the international spotlight. How did you land this historic interview, guys?
Funny story. So, one of our listeners...
Your mom.
My mom, yes. Well, she let us know that Kim was a big wolf head. She read it on one of those trivia machines at the Buffalo Wild Wings.
Oh, where she works?
Yes, she works at the Buffalo Wild Wings. When we heard, we sent him an email through his Teen Wolf fan page on GeoCities Korea.
The Supreme Leader received the request, and after determining he didn't have the power to kidnap or execute the two young men, he agreed to travel to their home in Hocking Hills, Ohio for an interview. This marks only the second time Kim has appeared on a podcast, the first being WTF with Marc Maron, because of course he was on WTF with Marc Maron.
Locked again!
Folks, we have a very special guest tonight. We're obligated to call him the world's biggest Teen Wolf fan, both in stature and in passion. The honeybee by the DMZ. Welcome to Klaus and Paz, the supreme leader himself, Kim Jong-un.
Thanks, guys. Big fan of the show and of Teen Wolf.
So, Supreme Leader, who is your favorite wolfie?
That's what we call the characters in Teen Wolf.
Oh, I know. Did you think I was lying when I said I was a big fan of your show?
No, no, man. It's cool. We just like to explain our hilarious in-jokes to new listeners.
Forget it, Fork.
Fork.
So, favorite wolfie, go!
It's gotta be Scott, right? The teenage wolf. He's so funny, like Marty McFly.
Man, Supreme Leader slamming on my boy Styles.
I don't even like beer.
Never say die.
Oh no, I love Styles. He reminds me of my college chum, Simon. We met at an audition for the musical Grease during my time at Liebefeld Steinholzi School in Switzerland.
Whoa, you went to school in Switzerland? An explanation! Jesus Christ, Kim, an explanation!
Oh yes, oh yes. From the movie. No, I studied abroad to broaden my horizons. I miss those wild days in Switzerland, performing in Greece, playing a character entirely unlike myself. Simon played Kaniki. Together we robbed those Swiss of all their chocolate.
What?
It sounds better in Korean. But standing on top of that Volkswagen coupe, singing Grease Lightning, there was a little bit of the wolf in both of us.
We caught up with the podcasters as they prepared for their big Fancast track panel at UltraCon in Atlanta, Georgia. Hey guys, so how have your lives changed after the big interview?
It's been amazing, absolutely amazing. There were like millions of people who heard a clip of us on the news.
I'll bet you got a big jump in downloads too.
We're up to 12.
Have you guys heard anything from the U.S. government? Pretty weird that they just let Kim flit over here without a big hubba.
We don't need to talk about that.
Hold the jello, fat boy. They could be anywhere.
We haven't talked to him, Mr. Defoe.
Whatever you say, boys. Wink.
Scheiße, they saw him. We have to go, Pa.
On it, Klaus. Wolfmobile, to us!
Police say to be on the lookout for two men, mid-20s, riding around on top of a creepy old van. Do not attempt to approach them, especially during tonight's full moon. I know it's hard to tell, but we here at the Fakest are all heartbroken over the loss of helicopter pilot Birdman Stan Buttram, who died tragically while being the same reckless dumbass he always was. Big Git, Malcolm McDowell, is here to tell you why Birdman Stan was so careless, and how nobody here at KCOM Studios could have possibly influenced his fatal decisions. Malcolm?
Good evening, one and all, and welcome to Birdman Stan Fly High. We've all thrilled to the eccentric escapades of Birdman Stan over the years. Who can forget the time he interrupted a State of the Union speech with his lazy eye in the sky?
60 years ago, when the Russians beat us into space, we didn't deny Sputnik was up there. We didn't argue about the science or shrink our research and development budget. We built a space program almost overnight, and 12 years later, we were walking on the moon.
Hang on to your nuts, boys!
Or when he along with the visiting actor Jeff Goldblum, flew a Raspberry Pi straight into the heart of an alien spacecraft.
You got that virus program, computer man?
It's a Linux system. I know this. I gotta find the right file.
Birdman Stan's doomsday clock started ticking April 74th at 5:15 p.m. when he crashed his chopper outside Dustin's neighborhood grill, resulting in several deaths and the destruction of a potential new lunch place.
Stan, let that banner fly.
Here we go. They say it, Polly. Oh, they're laughing. The big guy's hugging one of the waitresses. Would you look at that? Same thing got caught up in my chopper. I'm going down, Polly. Oh, this is gonna sting.
A few days later, Birdman Stan, of his own volition, flew over KCON Studios, covering the protests inspired by his previous crash. Warning, the following clip is disturbing.
What's going on?
Leanne, that's the wrong clip.
Oh gosh, sorry.
That sucker's gonna bust any seat. Oh, shoot. There went my Jesus nut. Them protester types better move their butts before I pepper their pies.
Jeez. Oh, my God!
Tragedy hit hard on that fateful day nearly 2 weeks ago now.
When we saw Stan's chopper go down in the middle of that protest, we took our time. Normally, we would have reacted faster, but this is Stan we're talking about. He's always okay. Although I guess there were a lot of protesters.
Oh my God!
He probably lost the ability to move, speak, breathe, and evacuated his bowels in excess of 22 minutes before he passed. Poor son of a bitch was conscious for all of it.
Tragedy hits just a skitch harder when it hits you this close to home. For 7 long years, Birdman Stan covered stories of all sorts, from his lazy eye in the sky, which he would invariably crash when he pulled some hot dog bullshit.
Stan, you're going to crash into that bus full of orphans who are on their way to their new homes.
Sorry, Polly, but old Chopper One does what she does.
Hopefully parking the chopper on the launch pad will keep you out of trouble as you cover the historic Demo Republican National Convention, taking place here in somewhere...
What did you say, Polly? Sorry, I butt bumped Chopper Four.
But Birdman Stan Buttram, he didn't emerge from the womb in Brookshire, Texas, with a pilot's license in his hand?
Mr. McDowell, we checked. He actually did.
Oh, Well, Birdman Stan Buttram emerged from that warm hovel, hidden within his mother's internal organs, with flying in his blood. And a certified pilot's license in his hand. He quickly expressed an interest in aviation.
Stan?
Hey, Stan. What do you want to be when you grow up?
Well, shoot, Mom. I reckon I'll be one of those fighter pilots.
Now, Stan, we ain't got the money for no fighter jet planes or nothing. But we could probably rig you up a copter with the old riding mower and some of those dolphin bones, what we bought in Corpus Christi.
Ooh, yeah. Chopper Stan, he's a man. Come your way before you can say damn. Bounce mid-fire.
No wonder, then, that Stan became a bona fide war hero during the Desert Gulf conflict in 1959, after saving the lives of countless soldiers, including a young Elvis Presley in 1959.
I made a lot of friends that I never would have made otherwise.
And then an even older Elvis Presley in 1975. Stan retired from active duty in 1999, launching a storied career as a news pilot that refused to shy away from danger.
Sorry, this is really hard. When Stan submitted his resume on ZipRecruiter, where smart dudes post their jobs to find the best candidates, I was a little concerned with how often he seemed to crash his copters. But, you know, after looking at his demo reel and seeing the dazzling stunts and compelling footage he'd helped capture, I really would have been a total assjack not to hire the guy on the spot.
Paul Defoe isn't the only member of the staff that Stan inspired passion in. Grace Hubbard Stafford, ace fakest reporter and bocce ball enthusiast, recalls a spark between them a number of years ago.
Oh, Stan, the one that flew away, I call him. We were covering a police standoff outside the Full House house. Bob Saget was inside, demanding that KFLH TV Channel 8 give him his old job back on Wake Up San Francisco. The problem? Neither the news station nor the program actually existed. It was a tense night, but Stan wasn't too worried about any of it. To be honest, it was pretty hot. Stan, how do you work these binoculars? I can't see shit.
Don't worry, Gracie. I'll get us right outside the window there. You'll be able to count the seams on Saget's wave. Sure as shooting.
Stan, no. We'll crash.
Maybe. We'll sure have fun doing it.
Paul, this new, hot, possibly single chopper pilot is gonna get us killed.
What? Who is this?
It's Grace. Paul, you've got to do something.
Sorry, Grace. I think my Little Caesar's hot and ready pizza is here. Gotta run. Good luck with whatever the hell it is you're talking about.
Shit.
Hold on to your gonad, soldier. We're about to tear through Uncle Jesse's attic loft right into his basement recording studio.
Oh, Stan, if this is it, there's only one man I want going down with me. We shared a moment. A lady never goes into details, but let's just say the 15 seconds it took for the chopper to crash are still the best 15 seconds I've ever spent.
A bold claim. How long did you and Stan see each other?
See each other? No, I never really talked to him again after that. Don't get me wrong. I'm thankful for the moment we shared. Paul put me on the socio-political beat, which kept me in D.C. for the most part. If I passed Stan in the hall, he'd tip his hat to me, but keep right on walking. I always wondered what we might have looked like as a couple, but now it's up to all those fakest fanficers.
Stan's good friend, Byron Seals, finds it hard to focus on the mythological weather since Stan died in a screaming coffin of his own design.
I mean, I didn't even know the guy that well. He seemed nice. Shame about what happened with Paul, though. Those kids were tight.
Hold the front door. What happened with Paul?
Well, I guess they had some sort of falling out over a girl Stan set Paul up with. Stan never really talked to me until we were shooting an Image promo a couple months ago.
Hey, weather dude, copter guy. We only have 10 minutes to shoot this promo before you guys go on live. Stand back to back and nod as I swing this camera around you.
So, weather guy, wanna grab some chow later? There's a new Thai place, Madame Kapow's. I hear they make it Texas spicy. It'll blow your kidney right out of here.
Whoa, dude. Have you even said one word to me in all the time we've worked here?
Well, shit, you got me. I'd normally ask old Polly Boy, but, well, you know.
What do you mean?
Oh, nothing that ain't worth a crap. Besides, ain't like I'm asking you to a Sadie Hawkins or nothing.
You know what? Sure. It's our food. That'll be fun.
You ain't kidding. All right. I gotta fly over some buildings blowing up and such. Reckon I'll catch you after the show.
Not if I catch you first, buddy.
Can we use that in the promo?
A lingering question. Did Birdman Stan introduce Paul Defoe to his ex-girlfriend? And, inciting incident, Cindy McNeil?
Shit!
We went to the fakest himself for answers.
Look, McDowell, I don't want to talk about that. It's in the past.
But what of the rumors that you treated Stan poorly after the breakup in retaliation for your failed relationship?
Poppycock. I use the full release technique every day to get a grip on my feelings over Cindy's cruel betrayal and sparkling eyes. I would never let my personal life bleed over into the newscast. I leave my muddy boots at the door, sir. Now screw off, I have to do my makeup.
Leanne, fakest executive producer in charge of production, sounded shaken and not ready for air when she reported the news about Birdman Stan's self-inflicted demise.
Paul, Birdman Stan is dead. The police found him next to his chopper with severe lacerations on his head and torso. He's dead. Really, really dead. The only way the police knew it was him was the fakest ID badge he had on him.
Okay, all right. When I took this job, I was excited, thrilled. But all this insanity? Paul's breakup? Mrs. Gormley? Stan? I thought we were here to cover fake news. But people are really dying here, like all the time. I need a minute.
But his fakest family aren't the only ones mourning the loss of Birdman Stan. From Twitter, Mayor Audra Reliant tweets,
Birdman Stan was a familiar sight in the skies, above somewhere west of New York City. I pray for his loved ones, if any, but I know we'll all sleep a little more sound tonight without his damn helicopter flying past our bedroom windows.
Even famous celibuster Ryan Reynolds got in on the act, saying,
Guys, that sucks about Birdman Stan. Honestly, though, who didn't see this coming? That dude was a psychopath. And that's coming from one of the two guys who ran a pizza place with that girl.
Birdman Stan Buttram, a true fake news hero. For the fakest, I'm Malcolm, not Roddy McDowell.
What the hell is that?
Sorry, Paul. I kind of got lost there for a second. Hit the wrong button.
Look, Leanne, we're all messed up about this, but we have a job to do, okay? Any fake journalist worth their salt is gonna keep it going. Even, especially when, the story you're covering happens to be real. Bottom line, shake it off, or I'm gonna hear about it from upstairs.
Sorry, Paul. Let's just move on to the next block. It's some ads. Oh, wow. A lot of ads.
Oh, I'm not surprised with our sales team. They know our audience. In fact, our ratings analyst is confident that anybody who ever even thought about checking out the newscast is probably tuning in right now. So, we sold the fuck out of it. We'll be back in half an hour, folks.
The actual size of an aspirin is 1/4 inch by 1/6 inch. Parallelogram. But the increased comfort you feel, especially when you take like 30 of them, is immeasurable. Aspirin, all the relief of a prescription medication, but with none of the doctors.
sick of all these dumb old restaurants.
I agree.
They make you eat stuff like vegetables they pulled out of the ground and tap water.
Yuck!
Chill the hell out! At Madame Tussauds Pizza Palace, a kid can eat like a kid and party with animatronic versions of all your favorite celebrities.
Who is Buddy Hackett?
Jimmy Fallon is staring at me with his creepy eyes.
Check out our new location about half a block from Toys R Us. At Madame Tussauds Pizza Palace, you can eat like shit and nobody cares. We also don't card for beer.
Catch Birdman Stan on the fakest. He takes the lazy eye in the sky right into the heart of the action.
Come pay tribute to fallen helicopter pilot Birdman Stan Buttram in a fakest news special. Birdman Stan, Fly High. Streaming live and recorded at thefakest.com.
To all celebrating the day, happy birthday and best wishes at the Giant Fakest Kids Club. Brought to you by McDonald's. Kids like Corey Beck, Sue Perman, Barack Obama, Chelsea Law, Ty Tass, R. Spinner, Trey Charlie, Beth Wright, Alexis Electra, Lorena Daly, Baby Mahogany, Leanne Snyder, Rudy Tootie on Duty, D.D. Violet, Alicia Jordan, Sam Shepard, Mafanwe Royce, Faust Flava T, Bedivere Brainstorm, Stinky Foot McNeil, Tim Delroy, Chris Pratt, Chris Pratt, Chris Chat, and Amy Spear. Happy birthday!
Here we go, folks. I tell you what, only $22.95 is back. Gas went up, hummus went up, the cost of my insulin went up, everything went up. But I tell you what, I'm going for 30 days only, offering this special deal to the fans of our dearly departed Birdman Stan.
This bird is going down.
Only $22.95 to do your whole basement. Waterproof it. I don't care how big it is, how long it is, as long as it's not as long and as big as a courthouse. Call right away. How much is that price again, Mr. Cameraman?
Was it $22.95?
Yes, that's right, $22.95. And remember, I can't call you. You gotta call me.
The truth. Your principal drinks absinthe, can't dance, gambles nightly, and
I can't stand the taste of new McDonald's broccoli bites.
Broccoli bites, now at McDonald's. It's a big hunk of flavor for you, not him.
Now, kids, tell me again. How'd you get these tickets to Killywood? Huh? It means only the place where dreams come true. Hey, I can't believe you just got them for free.
But they were. Our principal at school gave them to us.
Yeah. Haycom Studios and Curly World are the sponsors of Mostly A's and B's Day. If you do good in school, you can win a free ticket to Curly World.
Oh, yeah, I forgot. My son went there last year. Yeah, he had so much fun. On the rides. The shoes. Hey, look, you're free to go.
Can you take off these handcuffs, please?
All right, here, I'll get them. Look, wait a minute. I'm in the dark here.
Spywiz, case 101, the Dad Hummer. Dad Hummer has made his move. Use your spy with spyglass to keep him in sight as he skips down the street.
He's heading your way.
He's heading into a house down the block. Set up the Spywiz long-range microphone. You can hear the small sounds like they're right next to you, even through the walls of a house.
Oh, God, I've missed you, Sheila. Between stress at work and what with the disappointment my son Stevie is with his spy obsessions, you're the only light left in my life.
Oh, Archibald. Take me.
Oh, yeah. Nibble my ears.
What?
You've got them now, Stevie, because you've got SpyWiz. High-tech equipment that works way better than you'd expect a kid's store to work. Everything sold separately. New from SpyCo.
Now, back to the Fakers special report.
Birdman Stan, fly high. A hastily thrown together tribute to the man whose lazy eye in the sky drifted towards heaven far too soon. Brought to you by McDonald's, the place for food, fries, and fun, as well as a star-studded cast of sponsors.
Now, Paul Duffo.
Jesus, that felt like a lot of ads. Happy sales team? Great. Well, let's get back to the fucking news. What's up next, Leanne?
It's, holsters for gals on the... That's probably not appropriate, considering... Why don't you do this Bieber hit?
Sure. Whatever. A controversial pop star stands in the limelight again after butting up against his future family. According to fake reports coming in just now, Justin Bieber, 18 or however old he is being sued by Gene and Donald Bieber. Bieber. Two twins who revealed themselves to the world late last week. They emerged from a large wormhole atop the CN Tower in Toronto, wearing silver suits that sparkled in the sunlight, which some observers described as spacey.
Oh my gosh.
Holy cow.
Are you okay?
Ooh, yeah, that was a tough one. I tell you, I was hearing colors.
Hey, do you guys know how to cyberlink?
Oof, look at this place. What a dump.
This is horrible. Wow,
the sidewalks aren't even moving here.
And they're still driving here? And what is that? Is that a helicopter?
What, they still have those?
I thought those were banned after the Buttram Act of 2018.
Yeah, I don't know. That's what my cyberpad told me. I don't know.
And it's ugly.
Anybody here speak English or Canadian? Anyone?
We're looking for our dad. You may have heard him. You know, Justin Bieber?
You might have heard of him. Kind of a big deal.
We also want to let Stephen Hawking know that time travel is real. He'll be so thrilled.
We demand to see our father, Justin Bieber, and a lawyer. Well, maybe not answering because they know exactly who he is.
Oh.
Yeah. Well, first things first, we need to get off this tower. And they don't have a gravity pod here, so we're not going to get down any other way.
God.
We have to take the stairs? I don't know.
The sci-fi siblings are allegedly the result of the upcoming wedding of Bieber to his fresh-faced fiancée, Hailey Baldwin. The Biebs asked for Baldwin's hand in marriage only 1 month after they started dating, which marks the longest Justin Bieber has ever gone without screwing up a relationship.
I trusted you. Oh my God, I trusted you!
The Bieber babies staged a press conference shortly after their arrival on the front steps of New City Hall near Nathan Phillips Square in Toronto.
Greetings, citizens of 2018. I am Donald Bieber.
And I'm Gene Bieber. Together we are
the Bieber babies,
all grown up.
We demand nothing less than 100 million 2018 loonies from our father, Justin Bieber. Our lawyer, Steve Robertson, will read off the charges in the form of a feel-good pop folk song we wrote 5 minutes ago.
We demand relief for your bad behavior. If you love us, Dad, do us a favor. Compensate us for our stress and loss of status. Sure, Dad, your life is lush and lavish, but your asshole rep fuels your children's madness. Thank you, thank you. This former YouTube sensation's actions, specifically from 2018 through 2021, will cause irrevocable harm to the family name, creating a big flippin' hassle for my clients, even as it fuels their invention of time travel.
Speaking of, we'd still love to talk to Dr. Hawking.
Oh, honey, we'll talk later. Now, furthermore, Mr. Bieber's actions have trapped his descendants in a vicious cycle of poverty. Care to explain, Gene?
You see, jobs and housing in the future are assigned based on the douchiness quotient, or DQ, of the preceding three generations tabulated using data from Twitter, Facebook, TMZ.com, and the bodybuilding.com forums? Our genes are considered a disease. Bieber fever, the cyber press calls it.
The senior Bieber responded in a Snapchat Insta story late Thursday night.
Sup, freaks? Yo, this whole thing is whacked up, right? Those kids ain't got the Bieber swag. You know what? Hate is gonna hate. You dumbass space kids looking for some scratch? Sell your spacesuits to Jaden Smith or some shit.
The Insta story ends with the Biebs taking off on his hoverboard, expelling a wicked vape cloud while flipping his middle finger. We asked the Bieber baby's lawyer, Steve Robertson, what he thinks about their odds.
Oh, this case is the first of its kind, and it's an incubator for case law related to time travel, which, oddly enough, Justin Bieber seems to be directly responsible for.
Whatever happens, you can be sure Justin Bieber's latest single, WT Future, will be rocketing up the Billboard charts for as long as they exist, so around 32 more months. The trial begins, you know what? I don't actually know. It begins whenever or something.
I am Donald Bieber.
And I'm Jean Bieber. Together we are...
The Bieber Babies, all grown up.
This story brought to you by Def Jam Records, home of the Biebs.
Grab my new album, The Choice is by me, Jake Stein.
Shut the fuck up, Jake. We're going to get right back to mourning the preventable by only him death of Birdman Stan in just a minute. But first, this very important and lucrative commercial. It takes a hell of a lot of firepower to fuel the fake news. Hi, I'm Paul Defoe. And we only trust one hosting provider to handle the buttload of traffic our clickbait tweets bring to the site. Bluehost does it all. Use their simple dashboard to install WordPress. Access 24/7 customer support for help when you screw it up. They even have a money-back guarantee where if your website building experience sucks, they'll totally give you back at least some of your cash. They even include a free SSL certificate, which means Chrome won't freak out and throw up scary warnings about your site. For you super geeks, they even give you a shell account. Grab that! Sign up for Bluehost today and get your own cyberspace for just $3.95 a month. Just go to mysite.thefakist.com to get started. Don't send us the link to your site, though. We really don't care.
Oh.
Now, and with great relief, let's get back to the show. While most of us on the team remain somber tonight, the sales team is celebrating a record quarter with caviar and male strippers in Studio 7. It's funny how grief works, isn't it? Especially in a case like this, when the person's death was clearly his fault, with no outside influence to blame whatsoever. Finally tonight, a Las Vegas mother is in the crosshairs as a bitter battle brews with Delta United Airlines. Meet Franny Fluke, 30-something-ish underemployed buffet attendant at the Aqua Riviera Resort, Casino, and Notary located on the outskirts of the Nevada desert. She's a strange duck, a customer with a mix-up she doesn't care to fix.
What can I say? I just like the one they sent better.
When Franny arrived at the airport yesterday, she expected to pick up her 11-year-old son, Tommy Fluke. In what can only be described as an odd chance happening, Miss Fluke found a surprise awaiting her when the plane disembarked at approximately nobody cares o'clock.
When he first popped his puss out of the plane, I thought, Tommy, little shit.
The little shit Franny found wasn't Tommy, but another 11-year-old, Edward DeVries.
Eddie is just the sweetest little thing. When the little guy asked me to fetch him dinner with that little accent of his, how could I say no?
Did you have any concern about your biological son?
Nah, screw him. Eddie's just a plain better son. Little brat's been ungrateful since we moved here.
Delta United Airlines, the company who mixed up the two children, is working hard to get everybody back where they belong. But they were willing to admit it was a pretty big fuck-up.
It was a pretty big fuck-up.
Leanne, what the shit is going on?
It was a pretty big fuck-up.
Oh, shoot, Paul. I'm sorry. I heard a noise outside the control room and... God
distracted. I thought it was a shooter or something.
Jesus Christ, Leanne. We have an electrified lobby. Everybody knows that. We're fine. And we still have 8 more ads to do. Do you want the sales team to have to cancel their team-building tropical cruise? Because I don't.
I said I'm sorry.
Tell that to the water slide Kathy won't be able to go down in the middle of the ocean. Or the retired oil tycoon she was going to marry one night after too many Mai Tais.
Who gives a darn about him, Paul? Excuse my language, but who gives a flippin', dangin', crunchy darn about him? Birdman Stan is dead. He was such a sweet old guy. Remember when he flew that banner I made?
Oh, the banner you made completely of your own volition and without my involvement that eventually led to the death of Birdman Stan as well as several waitresses? Of course I remember that. We all do. It was only 2 episodes ago. You were so young then. So naive.
What? What the heck? Paul, don't you blame me for this. If you hadn't paved off that darn restaurant, none of this would have happened.
So what, Leanne? What do you want me to do? Accept responsibility and take the whole fucking showdown with me? The world needs us, Leanne. You said it yourself.
Well, then maybe I was wrong. As far as I can see, all the fake news seems to do is hurt real people.
Well, you know what? It didn't used to. Not before you walked in through that revolving door. You told me once that, to you, I am the fake news. If all the fake news does is hurt people, then what does that say about me?
I don't know, sir.
And now you're not even calling me Paul. What do you want? For me to take the blame for Stan's recklessness?
Well, if the shoe fits.
Byron, can't you see that I'm having a climactic argument with Leanne out here?
Paul, we both know Stan was your only friend.
Well, he was a friend, yeah.
A friend you cast away like Morpheus cast away his father Hypnos after they both fell in love with the West Wind.
What's he talking about, Paul?
To be honest, I usually don't know.
There's something you should know about your boss, Leanne. He puts on a good show. But if you piss him off, you better watch out.
What do you mean?
Ever wonder why Paul's been sitting Stan out so much lately? And giving him grief every time they talk? Thing is, Birdman Stan introduced him to his ex-girlfriend. You know, the one that broke his heart.
What was that? I couldn't hear you over that dramatic sting.
Stan died because of Paul blames him for Cindy dumping his sorry white ass.
How dare you?
Tell me I'm lying.
I never said you were lying, but how dare you call me out on it? My white ass is sorry, okay? Leanne's right. All I ever seemed to do was hurt the people I thought I'd fooled into loving me. It's been put into stark fucking contrast for me the past few months. I might be the first person to realize this, but maybe that's all the fake news is good for. Confusion, chaos, and pain. And now Stan's dead. My friend is dead. And it's all my fucking fault. I get that, okay? I fucking get it!
Paul! Calm down! You couldn't have known!
There's your fucking fake news, you ungrateful assholes! I tried to build something here, but all anybody ever does is turn against me! You're all just jealous because I'm so awesome at my job, you suckabisses! You know what? I'm gonna go. I'm done. Good luck finishing the show without me.
Byron? Think you can close out the show?
Screw that guy.
Well, I guess that leaves me. From KCOM Studios in somewhere west of New York City, this was the fakest. Look, folks, I don't know if we're gonna come back from this one. I mean, it's not like I'm a journalist or anything. So, and maybe for the very last time, go out there and have a heck of a night. I know I already have.
Okay, folks. Last karaoke artist of the night, straight from quitting his nationally syndicated fake news program, Mr. Paul Defoe!
This This goes out to a dear, dear friend. Fly high, buddy. Fly high.
They kill Birdman Stan.
Wake up, kids. We've got the dreamer's disease. Age 14, they've got you down on your knees. So polite, you're busy still saying please. Oh, why would you do that? Frenemies, who when they're down ain't your friend. Every night we smash their Mercedes Benz. First we run, and then we laugh till we cry. But when the night is falling, you cannot find the light, light. If you feel your dream is dying, hold tight. Style. The bad rich God's flying in for your trial. But when the night is falling, cannot find a friend. You feel your tree is breaking, just bend. You've got the music in you, don't let go. Music in you, one dance left, this world is gonna pull through. Don't give up, you've got a reason to live. Can't forget, you only get what you give. Good night.
Will Paul ever return from his karate sabbatical? Does Leanne have what it takes to report the fake news on her own? Will Birdman Stan's ghost show up in a special Christmas episode? You'll have to tune in to the next episode to find out. Same fakest time, same fakest channel.
Subscribe to The Fakest on Apple Podcasts, Stitcher, Google Play, or your favorite podcast app by going to thefakest.com. You'll get every episode when we release it. Follow us on Twitter, Facebook, or Instagram by following The Fakest News. That's Fakest with an I. See you next time.